Oh, this is Lover's Cove, babe.
Oh yeah, get a picture of that kid.
Alright, is he ready to roll?
What a cool kid.
We're here on Catalina Island. Today we're gonna explore the island a little bit and go on a little adventure.
Alright, here we go.
Whoa. Is everything secure?
No, not the type of bag.
I love taking Jackson on new adventures. Even though he doesn't like know what's going on, I feel like you're showing him the world.
Babe, you're getting passed.
Becoming a parent is like a huge deal. It's like a whole lifestyle change.
It is a little bit stressful because you have like this new thing that you love. You think about him all the time. I think about like the future a little bit more now, like what's he gonna need? You're vulnerable to this new, yeah, this new love.
Here we go.
Yay!
Hands up, Doctor!
Catalina Island was great. We had a lot of fun going on adventures. Mama. Jackson was pretty easy on this trip. Like, he passed with flying colors.
Jackson killed it.
I would honestly give him an A plus almost. Like, even the boat ride back to the mainland, it was his bedtime, but he was still a champ. No, we're headed home to Portland. Looks like we're gonna make it home in time for Jeremy and Audrey to have their baby.
How are you feeling?
Hungry, and I want some coffee.
Well, we'll get you some of that. We'll get you some coffee. How's baby girl feeling?
Good.
We're on our way to our second to last doctor's appointment, and it's just crazy that we're already here.
Definitely nervous. We have no idea when Audrey's gonna pop.
Kind of fun sitting on a time bomb. I know that's me saying it.
Yep, that's you saying it.
I think it's very difficult for man to understand like what a woman goes through during pregnancy. And
there's some excitement about it, some anxiety involved, you know?
They're not made to do that, and we are.
How are you doing?
Good.
You're at the end of the road here.
Yeah.
Like any day. Yeah. You having any action that you think is?
I definitely feel like she's lower.
That's a good sign.
We're 3 days away from my due date, so any day I could wake up and go through the most pain of my life. Like, I'm just so focused on like that right now because that's the next hurdle before me, and it's kind of overwhelming.
So in the scheme of things, yeah. Where does baby dropping fall on the, is that like the first step of preparation?
Yeah.
I mean, is that a sign of a couple weeks, or is that a sign of?
You are putting me in a really bad position. There is no way I can give you any kind of date or time. First babies are notorious for coming late. If you get to 41 weeks, you have a choice between being induced and continuing to be pregnant. We wouldn't let you go past 42 weeks.
Okay, that's the deadline. Definitely don't want to do that unless I absolutely have to.
I think I'm a little bit different than most pregnant women that I know that are like around this time of 40 weeks. They're more like, get this baby out of me, and I'm not really like that.
I think for me, like, I'm going into it with like, I want to have as natural unmedicated birth as possible, but I'm not gonna be one of those people that's like, you know, if I've been laboring for 60 hours, absolutely not.
I've seen a lot of women who want unmedicated births, and many of them do achieve it. But what I've noticed in the people that are more successful, there is a willingness that exists. You know that contractions hurt, and as labor goes on, it hurts more. And so if you have that willingness to let it come, we can keep going. When you start losing that willingness to take the next contraction, when you're starting to like pull away, you're dreading it, you're curling up, that's when pain crosses the line to suffering in my mind. And we can't let you suffer, right? Pain you can take, but suffering has a psychological component.
I'm definitely nervous, and there is a little bit of like fear because I don't really know what kind of pain it's gonna be, and I'm like just hoping that I can stick to my guns.
It's day 5, and I'm now back in the USA.
No, I really like this ride. It's very scenic.
Yeah. Being a passenger on a motorcycle is pretty cool. It's pretty awesome. Because man, you're looking all around and you're seeing all the scenery, and it was pretty spectacular, I thought. But then we were on the bike riding so much longer than I had anticipated. And my legs needed a break. Because for an average-sized person, you know, the legs just fall over naturally. But my legs always straddle still. So, you know, my inner thighs, man, after about 15 minutes, I'm like, okay, just take a deep breath. You can do this.
Oh, my gosh.
I know. Stiffen up after a while.
One thing I did learn about Chris on this trip, he would stop and he would get off and walked off and didn't tell me what he was doing. And I'd be like, well, why are we stopping? He did it a couple of times where he would stop and, I don't know, just do something. But it's like, whoa, wait a minute. What are we doing and why? And today, it definitely led up to an argument. When we were having dinner, he just left. And he was gone for a long time, and I was left by myself. I had no idea where he was, what he was doing. And I'm like, no, this does not work for me. Oh, I'm so mad at him. Like, where did you go?